They say if you dig deep enough, eventually you'll find that family trees grow seldom straight and are most often intertwined. As is the case when I retraced how it had come to be, my great-grandfather arrived in fortune from the Caribbean Sea. His name was James Innes, and at just 14 years old, he left his homeland of Barbados as a stowaway, I'm told. Never to return again, and no one knows just why, he'd leave his family to think the sea had took their only boy. The Sunday school headmaster, Jenny King was her name, would take James in as if her own, and with her he'd remain. Until he married Nancy Lake, 'twas the talk of the whole town. She's marrying that black man? He was the only one around. But deed she did, and deed they had, a family of their own. They stood their ground in fortune, till their children were all grown. True love endures criticism, James already knew. He'd seen it all before. It's what his own parents went through. His father was a black man on a plantation called The Risk. And what a risk he took when he decided he would kiss. The daughter of the owner of that plantation where he worked. Of course, her family was white, but they'd known each other since their birth. They both were born and raised in precisely the same place, but from very different circumstances and of a different race. They learned exactly what it was to let your true love reign, despite skin color or looks of disapproval and disdain. So love in spite of circumstance is a theme, it seems to me, and a flower that keeps blooming on the limbs of my family tree. You'll never know how much you'll learn or how far your roots will reach, but these stories are worth digging for and the lessons that they teach.